Hi, I'm Colin Smith from Photoshop Cafe, and today I'm going to show you three things in Adobe Premiere Pro that's going to help your aerial editing. First of all, I'm going to show you how to vary the speed to add some excitement and drama to your shots. Then I'm going to show you how to remove those little bumps in your shot using Warp Stabilize. And then finally, I'm going to show you how to compose 4K footage into a 1080 time frame. If you don't have Premiere Pro, if you get the Seagate DJI Fly Drive, it comes with a free 2 month trial of Premiere Pro so you can follow along and do these tutorials. While I was on location at the beach, I was able to use the Seagate DJI Fly Drive to take the footage off the microSD card and upload it directly onto the drive through the built-in SD card reader. That way I was able to have all the footage ready to go with me, and then I could reuse that card. So what I've done is I've loaded it all into Premiere Pro, and I've got a few clips here. Now look at my previous video and you can see how I assembled the timeline. We're going to start by creating a dramatic speed ramp effect. So let me just hit the spacebar to play this clip, and you notice we've got this water coming up over the rocks. And then it kind of splashes. It gets a little bit dramatic, but we can make it a lot more dramatic by playing with speed. Another thing you might notice, see how that's going at about half speed? That's because I shot this at 60 frames per second, and now I'm playing it back on a 30 frame per second timeline. And this is how we create slow motion in camera, and this is going to give us much better results. If you don't have any 60 frames per second, you can still do this effect. It's just going to look better if you've prepared in advance. All right, so let's have a look here. We've got this water, and we're going to have it split about here, where we want it to be exciting. Now we're going to take the razor blade tool here, and we're just going to cut. So what that's done is it split that clip into two. Now we're going to make the first part of the clip faster, and we're going to make the second part of the clip slower. So let's right-click on the first part of the clip, and we're going to go up to speed duration. And you'll see this is where we can change it. So I'm going to change the speed to 200. And what that's going to do is it's going to double the speed. So what we're going to do is we're going to make sure the ripple edit is on to avoid any gaps. Because when we double the speed, it's actually going to shorten this duration by 50% in order to show the same footage, because now it's playing at double speed. And Premiere Pro can do that automatically by turning that option on. Just click OK. And if we go to the beginning here, we'll see, there we go. And then it cuts to that slow motion. Now let's make this even more dramatic. We're going to right click here, go back up to speed duration. And this time we're going to do the opposite. We're going to slow this down to 50% speed. So it's really going to emphasize that slow motion. Click OK. Notice it doubled the length because now it's playing at half speed. It's going to take twice as long to play the same footage. Okay, let's preview this. And you can see how much more dramatic that is now. All right, so one of the things we can do too is we can adjust this later. If we want to make it even more dramatic, we can go to speed duration and let's change it to 250. And click OK. And now we'll play it. Notice it's going to be much more dramatic. There we go. And you can see that kind of freezes that motion, but still kind of keeps it going, adds a lot of drama. All right, let's look at a second thing. Let's look at adding some 4K footage into the 1080 timeline. So why would you shoot 4K if you're going to be editing in 1080, for example? Well, because when you do, it gives you a lot more latitude because it's a much bigger file. So I'm going to take this clip here. And let's just double click in here and we can find a shot. So let's start about here. And I'm just going to end it about there. So I hit the I key and the O key to set the in and out points. And now we're just going to drag this into our timeline here. So if you look here, you can see this is the full clip, but now it's cropped when we add it in here because it's much larger. And this is great with working with a drone because you can make it look like you were flying much closer than you really were. You can emphasize your subject, but yet you're still keeping a safe distance. All right, so let's have a look at how we would recompose this in the window. Make sure it's selected in the timeline. Then what we want to do is go up to the Effect Control tab and click on there. If you don't see it there, go under Window, Effect Control. And this is where we're going to be adjusting it. We've got our position and our scale. Now, there's a couple of ways we can do this. We can just double click here, making sure it's still selected, and you could drag it around to recompose it. And notice its position changes. The other way is you could actually just click and drag it around using these sliders. The other thing we can do is we can play around with the scale, because look at how much scale we have to play with without losing any quality. So, you know, you might want to recompose it to somewhere there. So now it's at 91%. And we can move it around and you can see that. And we're not going to lose any quality at all because we've given ourselves that little extra latitude by working in 4K. Let's examine this shot where we're flying in towards land, but notice here as I turn a little bit. Now that happens a lot. Sometimes when you're flying and you want to correct course, you do it as smoothly as you can, but sometimes it can be a little jarring. Let's watch this shot again. See, that kind of jars the viewer out of a nice smooth shot. So what we can do is we can actually smoothen out these little turns using warp stabilize. So what we're going to do is go to where it says effects down the bottom here. Hit the search bar and start typing in warp stabilize. And then you'll see the warp stabilizer tool. Now just drag it onto the clip. And now you're going to see it's going to analyze. And if we look under the effect control, you can see warp stabilizer right there. And what it's doing right now is it's analyzing this clip. So there's two steps. The first step is it's going to analyze all the frames. And then the second step is it's going to stabilize it. So let's see how it works. All right, let's have a look at this shot now. See how it just smoothens out those jarring effects? Let's look at before and after. See how jarring that is? Let me just play it. And then you turn on the warp stabilizer and notice it's just going to smoothen out those movements. All right, there's one adjustment that I sometimes like to make though, because right now if you look at the method, we're using subspace warp. Sometimes it can give kind of a jello effect around the edges. In this case, it isn't, but if it does, you can choose position, scale, and rotation, which is actually my favorite setting. And let's have a look at it now. And there we go. See how it just really smoothened out those movements. Now that we've assembled our timeline here in Adobe Premiere Pro CC, we want to be able to share this video with the world. And the way to do that is to just choose File, Export, Media. And then it's as simple as just choosing a preset. You can see there's a lot of presets built in. In this case, I'd be using a YouTube 1080p preset. And then you just click that, and then you can encode your video. So I hope you enjoyed this video. This is part two of a three-part series. The first part, I showed you how to ingest your footage and create a rough assembly on the timeline. In the next video, I'm going to show you three things: how to do a cinematic color grade, how to add music to your timeline, and also how to finish it with some titling. So I hope you enjoyed this. Thanks for watching.